joined by Tom Rand, who's a very successful entrepreneur, the head of the Mars Clean Tech program, as well as I understand you're on the government's Clean Energy Advisory Task Force, and you're now the author of Kick the Fossil Fuel Habit. So a man of many hats, and I'm hoping we can take a moment today just to talk about the transition to a low-carbon economy.
The world is going to decarbonize. This is not negotiable. And I think if we're smart about it, we would think about being a net seller or a net buyer into that market. This is the single largest market of the 21st century, which is low carbon infrastructure. Mm-hmm. Jurisdictions that figure that out and get ahead of the game will be selling solutions to the rest of the world, just like Silicon Valley still sells us microchips and software solutions in the internet. If we grab 2% of the global clean tech market by 2020, our clean tech sector would be bigger than either our automotive or aerospace sector. And that's how big this global opportunity is.
Right.
I mean, the energy system is the most complicated machine mankind has ever built.
That's right.
That includes internet, right? So as we put intelligence onto that grid, this is the single largest infrastructure build-out in human history, bar none. And again, I think you look to your strengths. We have networking strength in this province.
Right.
We do have very good financial ingenuity in this province.
Japan and Germany produce twice as much GDP per unit of energy than we do.
Exactly.
And this is not because they don't have a winter. It's not because they don't have a steel industry and an automotive sector. Last time I checked, they had heavy industry in Japan and Germany. Strategically, it was decided, for reasons other than climate disruption, to price fossil fuels. It was about energy dependence. And that's had companies respond by investing in the capital infrastructure required to produce cars and sweaters and trains and buildings at half the energy per unit of economic output than we have. So the good news for us is that's very low-hanging fruit. We have yet to make that capital, those investments. My building, for example, in Planet Traveler, we're 75% below business as usual in terms of our carbon emissions. And we're more profitable as a hotel for having done it.
But if you as a CFO regard the cost of energy and just purely hedging your exposure to rising energy costs,
then you'll make the capital expenditures the Japanese and the Germans already have. So it's ultimately about economic competitiveness.
So, you know, one of the challenges I've been pointing to, by the way, is somebody who does support a carbon tax, people say, oh, carbon taxes kill jobs.
Look at BC. There's an article in the New York Times recently talking about how successful BC's carbon tax is in shifting jobs around. So for one thing, look, it can be revenue neutral. Tax and dividends, you tax carbon, and you give the money back out of it. Two, it does unlock efficiencies in the economy that you wouldn't otherwise unlock. And there are going to be industries that hurt, and there are going to be industries that gain.
Right.
That's the nature of every economic transition. But to think that we're not going to make an economic transition to low carbon infrastructure because we want to hang on to industries of the past means that we wouldn't have an auto sector because the horse and buggy people would have got mad.
Right.
Like, we're not going to have looms because the people who knit by hand would have been mad. The economy needs to evolve. It needs to evolve to a low-carbon infrastructure. The only way you're going to do that is by taxing carbon. Nuclear, aerospace, automotive, the internet, none of these industries came out of nowhere. All of them had some kind of strategic government support.
I mean, the global solar prices have dropped 75% in the last 3 years. This is largely because they don't need a tariff program in Germany and so on.
That's the role of policy, is to set the stage, prime the pump, and let the private sector take over. But clean tech is like every other major industry. We simply require the attention of government to say, that's a strategically important industry. I'm going to support that industry because I think there's going to be economic benefit from having done it. The internet had it, the automotive sector had it, clean tech had it. There's nothing wrong with it.